Hello and greetings from Iceland. It's time to talk about the hot highway again, since I just did yet another thermal scan there and I came back with rather conclusive results. The geothermal area is still expanding and in fact so much that those who travel this road, they don't always need a fancy thermal drone like me to see that something is not like it should be. But the weather conditions do however decide how much steam is visible, so I prefer to use the good old thermal drone when it's cold outside. And for those who are new to this topic here on the channel, this increased ground heat under Iceland's highway number one, less than 20 kilometers away from Reykjavík, was first detected 18 months ago. And since then, I've been flying over there every now and then in order to see and map how this develops with a thermal drone. And the geothermal areas, they can undergo changes and the surface changes, they might have something to do with just general changes in the pipeline network under the hot springs. Earthquakes and tectonic movements, they can also trigger such changes. Just like magma getting closer to the surface, and we do indeed have magma at a little depth there, but overall this is one of the things that scientists cannot answer fully, and this particular event, it wouldn't be as interesting as it is if it wasn't for the fact that this occurs under Iceland's highway number one that runs over the plate boundaries around there just by a central volcano, Hengill. So there is always this chance that we might be seeing some kind of build-up to something bigger. But again, those could just as well be normal changes in the geothermal area. But this does, however, provide me with a unique chance to monitor those changes with a thermal camera mounted on a drone. So back to the road. This is how it looked a few days ago. And we have those two main areas on either side of the highway heating up, and this part here, this is where it started strong, and that part has actually changed the least, and it is at the other side of the road where most of the action is. And when I did my first filming around there, all the heat was in the road embankment, but that is clearly changing. It is very easy to detect new steam holes in the ground, quite large some of them. So this new geothermal area, it is spreading for sure. And by the same side of the road, we found another area. At first, there was a cold area between those two spots. That I could see clearly through the first scans. But now, it looks as those two spots are about to merge into one. And when I'm backing the drone from this area, I don't remember seeing those spots there before, or the spots that are coming into the frame now. But I will have to look at them better through my next scan, and I will need to scan a larger area next time. But when we look at this spot here, it is very clear that it wasn't here 18 months ago. But when I was here in September scanning, I didn't see that spot very clearly with my thermal camera. So it looks as the temperature there has been fluctuating, but I did however have better conditions to scan during my last trip. And then I noticed this. It looks as the heat is following perhaps a fracture there, but it's not as hot as the other areas I was scanning. And when I did the low pass over that, the sun started to shine. So I didn't do more that day. And the most obvious conclusion was the expanding hot area between those houses. The ground between them was cold, but I will however need to go through all my footage from there, all the 7 trips. And if this continues, it might be well worth it to analyze it and make it into a map. And since we are talking about geothermal systems undergoing changes, I will have to mention the geothermal area by Geysir hot springs, the most famous such areas in Iceland. And last week we got some news from there regarding many of the hot springs powering up. And this occurred while I was in Reykjavík, so I was wondering if I should do the 200 km detour to film there. But I decided to skip it this time. There was no obvious reason for those changes by Geysir. No recent earthquakes or any kind of events that we could relate to this change in the geothermal system. So Icelandic experts have been saying that those are just general changes in the plumbing under there. And that's just how it is. But my photo and video stock from this area, it could be better. So it was very tempting to take off and do the tour. But we are very early in the winter, so I was thinking if I'm going to film Geysir soon, I want more snow and a nicer background than we have now. But there is no denying to it that it would be interesting to take the thermal drone to the Geysir area, and I plan to do so. The winter is coming and that helps a lot with the thermal drone. It loves the cold and I've not been as busy as I was a year ago when the Grindavík event took all my time. So it's a bit easier for me now to move around and I am thinking about ways to use the thermal drone more. But until then, I have other videos like the one I was showing you from my last tour. Another area on the Reykjanes Peninsula that has been warming up and there were earthquakes there recently. So I'm sure that many of you have been waiting for that video. And it's my plan to finish it and upload it this weekend. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.